Hello everyone, today we will see Retrieval Performance Evaluation Part 2. So learning outcome for this session is, evaluate the precision at 11 standard recall levels using interpolation formula, and students will be able to evaluate retrieval performance of algorithms for individual query. So just recall the definitions of recall and precision. What is recall? How many relevant documents has been retrieved out of total relevant documents? And what is precision? How many relevant documents has been retrieved in the answer set? So consider this example. In this example, for a given information request, there are 3 relevant documents, and the result of the system is as shown. So 15 documents are retrieved in the answer set. Now let us calculate the precision and recall. So first relevant document is D56. So in the answer set, we are having 3 documents. So recall will be 1 upon 3, that is 33.3%, and precision will also be 1 upon 3, that is 33.3%. Now for the second relevant document, that is which is nothing but D129, here there are total 8 documents in the answer set. So recall will be 2 upon 3, that is 66.6% recall, and precision will be 2 by 8, that is 25%. So 25% precision at 66.6% recall. For the third document, now we are having 3 relevant documents, and the third document is also retrieved. So we are getting 3 upon 3, that is 100% recall level. Whereas precision, out of 15 documents, 3 are relevant, so 20% precision. So 20% precision at 100% recall level. So when you will obtain 100% recall level? Just now we have seen. So again, pause the video and think for a moment. So yes, when all the relevant documents are retrieved in the answer set, we can say that we are getting the 100% recall level. So here is an example that we have already seen, that 3 relevant documents are retrieved in the answer set. Now we have to plot a graph of precision versus recall for 11 standard recall levels. But the example that we have seen, we have got only 3 recall levels. Again, these are not the standard recall levels. So how to obtain this precision at standard recall levels? So we have to use this interpolation formula. So what is interpolation formula is? We have to check the maximum precision at the recall level from RJ to RJ plus 1 if we want to calculate the precision for RJ, which is nothing but P of RJ is equal to max of RJ less than or equal to R less than RJ plus 1 P of R. So for example, precision at recall level 30% is the maximum precision of recall levels between 30 to 40%. So now let us calculate the recall levels for the given example. So precision for standard recall levels using interpolation formula will be, now we are having the first recall level is 33.3%. So for the recall level 0, 10, 20 and 30, which are less than or equal to this 33.33%, the precision will be same, which is nothing but 33.33%. Next recall levels 40, 50 and 60 are in between 50 to 60. So which is nothing, 60 to 70, which is nothing but the recall level of 66.6. So precision at this level is 25%, which will be interpolated for this 3, that is 40, 50 and 60% recall level. And the next recall level is 100%. So the recall levels 70, 80 and 90% will get precision of 20%, which is same as the recall level of 100%. So assume that here we have received 33.3. Also, we are having 38% recall level. So 33.3 and 38% recall level are between 30 to 40. So whose precision is maximum that we are going to take? So thus, we have obtained the precision for this 11 standard recall levels, and then we have plotted a graph of precision versus recall. Now consider this example. Here there are 2 algorithms. And we are having this average recall versus precision graph. Now, this algorithm is performing better for lower recall levels, whereas the other algorithm is performing better for higher recall levels. So thus, we can use this precision versus recall graph for comparing the retrieval performance over a set of example queries. In the previous lecture, we have seen that the algorithm will run for n number of queries. We will find the average and then we will plot a graph. So here, these graphs are, or these graphs our plot after getting this average of the precisions running for set of examples. But there are some situations where we want to compare the retrieval performance of the algorithm for individual query. We need to see that which algorithm is performing better for the given query. So for this, we need to use this single value summaries. So what can be the single value summaries? Nothing but single precision value for each query. Instead of averaging, we will find a precision value. So for example, summary of corresponding precision versus recall that we can take, or we can take precision at specific level. So there are some methods for finding the single value summary. So first is average precision at seen relevant documents. So find the average of all the precisions obtained after each relevant documents observed. So consider the example which we discussed. We have got these three precisions. So we can take the average, and 0.63 will be the average precision for the seen relevant documents. Second method is R precision. So compute the precision at the rth position in ranking, where R is the total number of relevant documents for current query. So for example, in this example, there are 10 relevant documents. So in the answer set, from in the first 10 documents, how many documents are relevant that we need to find? So if you look at this example, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So 4 are the relevant documents. So R precision value will be 0.4 or 40%. Consider the second example. Here, the number of relevant documents are 3. So how many documents are retrieved in the answer set which are relevant? So in the first 3, only one document is relevant. So R precision will be 0.33. That is R precision. Next is precision histogram. So this histogram is used to compare the retrieval performance of the two algorithms. So for example, this RPA is for algorithm A, whereas RPB is for algorithm B. So here we are finding the difference in between the precision value of algorithm A and algorithm B. So if the difference is same or zero, we can say that both algorithms have equal performance. If the difference is greater, we can say that algorithm A is performing better than algorithm B. And if the difference is minus or negative, we can say that algorithm B is better than A. Now look at this histogram. So we have run 10 queries. So if you look at the histogram, you can see that the query number 4 and 5 is having the difference of negative. It means that algorithm is B is performing better for query number 4 and 5. Whereas for the rest of the queries, algorithm A is performing better. Also, we can do the statistics, or we can store the statistics about the execution of that particular algorithm. So what can be the summary table? So number of queries used in the task, total number of documents retrieved by the queries, total number of relevant documents which are effectively retrieved when all the queries are considered, and total number of relevant documents which could have been retrieved by all the queries. So from this stored data, we can have different queries and find out the result of that particular algorithm. Now, problems with the precision and recall are, so here, for calculating this precision and recall, we require the detailed knowledge of the documents in the collection. But with the large database, such knowledge is unavailable. So precision and recall are related measures which capture the different aspects of set of the retrieved documents. But there are some situations where we need to combine these two, and it will be more appropriate when we'll combine this. So next is that precision recall measure effectiveness or the set of queries which are processed in the batch mode. But in day-to-day life, we see that the interactivity is a key aspect of the retrieval process. Unless user is satisfied, he or she will not stop the process. Also, these two measures are easy to define when there is a linear ordering in the retrieved documents, but the systems with weak ordering, precision and recall might be inadequate. So there are the alternative measures which can be used to calculate the performance. So one is harmonic mean, where this is a single measure which combines recall and precision. So if you look at the formula, the harmonic mean for the jth level will be 2 upon 1 upon R of J plus 1 upon P of J, where R of J is the recall at jth level and P of J is precision at jth level. So F assumes to have a value in between 0 to 1. So just pause the video and think when you'll get the 0 value for as an F measure, or harmonic mean will be 0 or 1 in which condition? So it's obvious that 0 means no relevant document has been retrieved, whereas 1 means all the rank documents are relevant. Now, instead of combining these two, there are some situations where user is more interested in either recall or in precision. So here E of J is the major, or it is the E major which combines both, but still you can give the you can decide to whom you should give the more interest. So if B is 1, it will be treated same as harmonic mean. If B is greater than 1 means you are more interested in precision, and if B is less than 1, it means that you are more interested in recall. Now, when we are calculating this recall and precision, it is the assumption that the set of relevant documents in the query is same independent of the user. But in real life, it's not the every user has different interpretation for the relevance of the document. So some user will say that document A is more relevant, whereas for the other user, A will not be that much relevant. So we need to consider user-oriented measures. So consider that R is a set of relevant documents, A is the answer set. Now, what is set U? Relevant documents which are known to the user. Whereas set RK is that relevant documents known to the user and which are retrieved. And RU is a set which are the relevant documents which were previously unknown to user, and now after retrieving, they are known to user. So what is the coverage? Fraction of documents known to the user which are retrieved, which is nothing but mod RK upon mod U. And what is novelty? Fraction of relevant documents retrieved which are unknown to user, means RU upon RU plus RK. So high coverage means system is finding most of the relevant documents user expects to see. And high novelty ratio indicates that system is revealing many new documents which were previously unknown to user. Also, we are having the measures relative recall, which is the ratio of number of related documents found to number of documents user expected to find. Whereas recall efforts, number of documents user expected to find to number of relevant documents examined to find the relevant documents. So these are the measures which can be used to calculate the retrieval performance of the system. Thank you.